What is going on, everyone? Welcome back to the world according to Briggs, and a video about your fears. What do you fear the most? Spiders, airplanes, snakes, serial killers? Everybody has something they fear. Chapman University in California conducts a survey every year or so where they ask people what they fear the most. They give almost 100 choices, and the respondents select not afraid, slightly afraid, afraid, or very afraid. In today's video, we will look at the 10 things Americans fear the most and what percentage listed those 10 as afraid or very afraid. This is a very interesting subject, and I really hope it does well. Maybe we could do more of them. At the end of the video, I will list some that you may have thought were going to be in the top 10 that weren't. Let's take a look. Number 10, biological warfare. Biological warfare agents are microorganisms like viruses, bacteria, fungi, or toxins that basically give humans, animals, plants disease. Basically kills off everyone eventually. They also have things like nerve agents and blood agents, which pretty much kill you right away. I was a little surprised at this one, that it's so high on the list. I thought you had to be in the military to really understand how ugly biological warfare can be. You have to go through these classes when you're in the military on biological warfare, and they're ugly. Nerve agents, blood agents are the absolute worst, and they are a horrible way to die. But 49.3% of the respondents said that they are afraid or very afraid of biological warfare. Number 9, pollution of the oceans, rivers, and lakes. Now, first of all, in 2019, that was number 2. Things have changed. One of the biggest reasons that's changed is the news has gone on to other things. They've got bigger things to talk about than what's going on with the ocean, rivers, and lakes. This should be a legit fear for everyone. I mean, we get a lot of drinking water and a lot of food from the oceans, lakes, and rivers. So it could really affect us if they get so polluted that we're just basically eating toxic fish and drinking toxic water. Now, back in the 70s and 80s, it was so much worse, and we've made great strides to make pollution in oceans, rivers, and lakes less of a thing, but it's still there. So much so that 50.8% of the respondents had that as afraid or very afraid. Number 8, cyber terrorism. This is another one that I could totally see. It's not something I really ever thought about, but if I do sit down and think about it, yeah, this is kind of a fear. Cyber terrorism, I'm sure most of us have heard of it, and you might not know what it is. Cyber terrorism is the politically motivated use of computers and information technology to cause severe disruption and widespread fear in society by taking down satellites, taking down internet, telecommunications, just basically disrupting our lives. Think about how many things are connected to the internet that we need on a daily basis. There was a time, if you didn't hear from a loved one for, you know, 2 or 3 hours, you'd just see them at home later on or the next day, whatever the case may be. These days, if you're trying to get a hold of a loved one and you haven't heard from them in 2 hours because of cell phones and everything else, there's probably a problem and you start calling out bloodhounds and the police. So think about what happens if, let's say, another country just disrupts our whole system and we don't have internet or cell service for months at a time while we try and figure out what's going on. That is something that could happen. Everything like not being able to communicate with your doctor to ordering a pizza could be shut down overnight. Cyber terrorism is different from cyber crimes, like all that ransomware and people hacking into your computer and taking all your information. That's another thing entirely. Cyber terrorism is when they basically go after the whole system and shut down a country. I used to think AOL not letting you cancel service with them was cyber terrorism, but I was wrong. That was just annoying. 51% of the respondents said that cyber terrorism has them afraid or very afraid. Number 7, economic or financial collapse. Now, this one is a personal one where you're going to claim bankruptcy or something like that. It's not talking about the whole economy or anything like that, or the country or the state, the city, whatever. They're talking about your own financial situation. You lose a job, you end up on the street, things like that. There was a study a couple years ago on one of our videos where I'd read a stat that said 1 in 5 Americans are one paycheck away from living in their car or on the street. Total financial collapse. Living check to check is no way to live your life. And I mean, I'm not saying you just shouldn't. Some people are in a situation where they can't help it. That's just how it is. But while I was doing research for that video, one of the best piece of advice was this economist guy. He was saying that you want to lower your stress, you want to live a happier life, make sure you have enough savings to keep you going 3 months without a paycheck. Ideally, you know, you'd really like to have a whole bunch of money where you can just go a couple years without a paycheck, but 3 months is like the bare minimum. If you've got that, I'm sure this fear kind of goes away. I lived like this for quite some time in my young adulthood, and it was stressful all the frickin' time. Soon as I could actually not have to live like that, I can honestly say I was a much happier person. On the community tab on this channel earlier today, I asked that question, what do you fear the most? And this was one of the most common things said on there, that people fear bankruptcy or losing their job and ending up on the street. 54.8% of the respondents said this is something they are afraid of or very afraid of. Number 6. A pandemic or a major epidemic. Obviously, what we're going through across the entire planet right now has kind of pushed this one way up on the fear list. I'm sure around 2018, 2017, when they did this study, it was maybe in the top 50. But here it is at number 6, because we know about it, we're living through it, and for most of us, our world's been turned upside down because of a pandemic. So this is a legit fear for just about anyone. Totally understand this one. And cue the conspiracy theorists in the comments section. 55.8% of respondents said that they were afraid or very afraid of a pandemic or major epidemic. Number 5. Widespread civil unrest. This is another one that climbed the ranks this last year. Protesting, picketing, complaining, that's all part of America. I mean, that's what we do. It's in our Constitution. We have the right to free speech, and part of that free speech means we could protest and picket things and complain. But when it turns into a riot or basically civil unrest, total chaos going on, it's a different situation, and it scares the hell out of people, especially the people that are living in the city that aren't involved in the civil unrest. I'm here in Portland. Talk to anyone that's a longtime Portland resident. They hated what was going on in Portland summer of 2020. Myself, I've been in a few riots in my day. LA riots with the military. Again, actually the Pope came to Laguna Seca in Monterey, California, and we had to protect him, and there was full-on riot there too. It sucked, and it's kind of scary when you get a whole bunch of people that have destruction or mayhem in their brain and they're all acting together. That's a scary thing. During the riots here in 2020, I went down to film. I was not involved in the riots. I just went down to film and get some footage, and it was pretty interesting, and it got a little scary at times. Now, it's just not the riots and the protesting. You also have the fear of like a race war or class warfare. It's happened in many other countries before, so theoretically it could happen here too. But 56.5% of the respondents said that they are afraid of widespread civil unrest or very afraid of it. Number 4. People I love becoming seriously ill. Now in 2019, this was number 3, so it dropped back one. And this kind of gives me a little hope for humanity. This is a fear we should all have. If you don't have this fear, I don't know, in my opinion, you're not living your life right, and you're probably a hermit. This is a constant fear of mine, being a husband and dad and having brothers, sisters, and a lot of good friends. I fear this all the time. Over the last year, I've had a few friends pass away from illness and one relative. That just makes the fear stronger in you. I mean, it should be something that's always in the back of your head, but when it happens, especially a couple times, it comes right to the front. So I would have put this one down at number 1 or 2 myself. This is also one that everyone said in the community post I put up. It was the serious illness and the bill they get from the insurance company after the illness. 57.3% of respondents said this is something they are afraid of or very afraid of. Number 3, a loved one contracting coronavirus. Obviously, this is a new one, and here it is at number 3. I mean, in 2018, it wasn't even on the list. In 2019, it was barely on the list. And here we are, 2021, because of what went on in 2020, it shows up here. And it should. I mean, we've had 755,000 deaths due to coronavirus. It's a lot of people. That means a lot of people have been affected by it and should cause a serious amount of fear. So I kind of threw this little pool around here and asked everyone that works for World According to Briggs what their biggest fear is. One of the girls put getting gum in my hair. That was her number 3. Getting gum in my hair. That's a legit fear, I guess, if you got long hair. But 58% of respondents said that a loved one contracting coronavirus is something they fear or are very afraid of. Number 2. People I love dying. Now, just across the board dying. So I think this one could kind of bleed into some of the other ones, like becoming seriously ill or the coronavirus, but they actually have this as one that they could choose. And a lot of people chose this one. Like the other ones I was talking about, this should be a fear for all of us. It is a scary thought thinking someone you love is going to pass away. It's different when they're 80 and poor health, that's acceptable. But a lot of the people we love die at 20 in car accidents and things like that. So this is a totally legit one. In 2019, 2019, it was number 5. And I imagine coronavirus and everything else that's been going on here in the United States has played a big part in this one moving up the list. 58.5% of respondents said that they are afraid or very afraid of people they love dying. All right, before we get to number one, don't forget we have another channel called On This Day. There's a link down below. We'd love it if you went over there and watched some videos and subscribe. All right, on to number one. And number one, corrupt government officials. Wow, there's a U-turn. We go from losing loved ones and the coronavirus and becoming seriously ill to the frickin' government. But this one has been number one for decades. I mean, decades and decades. My understanding, the fear of the government becomes more and more of a thing as we develop new intelligence agencies. Like, it peaked when we established the FBI and the CIA and Homeland Security. Really, I think this is just a fear of people using power incorrectly. This, I guess, is a legit one too. I've worked for the military and I've seen how it operates and I know the rules that they go by. So I'm really not as afraid of that because I know it's really, really, really hard for like the government to turn the military on you. But anything can happen. You know, I mean, something weird can happen next week and everything I just said goes out the window. It's just the world we live in. And corrupt government officials is not a fear that's exclusive to the United States. I mean, every single country has this to a degree and always has. Think of all the things going on in the world right now. People think that the whole COVID-19 thing is part of a government conspiracy and corrupt government officials and everything else. Then you got all the election stuff. It just goes on and on and on. And when all that stuff settled, we'll be on to something else that we don't trust the government for or corrupt government officials in the future. It's how we work. So this one I'm not surprised at, but I am surprised at where it showed up and what percentage of the people actually put this on here. 79.6% of respondents said they are afraid or very afraid of the government or corrupt government officials. Okay, bonus time. So here's a few that were on the list, but not in the top 10 that you might think probably should have been. Global warming and climate change was number 13. Governments tracking your personal data was number 16. Corporations tracking your personal data was 17. Nuclear war was 22. White supremacists are 23. High medical bills, 24. Just overall terrorism was 31. There's a whole bunch of other ones down here like sharks at 51. Dying in general was 53. Being replaced by robots was 62. Reptiles, 67. Antifa was 72. Illegal immigration was 76. Murder hornets, 77. And clowns were 94. All right, everyone, that's today's list. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope you got some information out of it. It was a little bit different. Really hope you found it interesting. All right, everybody have a great day. Be nice to each other.